Hey y'all, welcome back to another week of What's for Dinner. On Monday, we were craving like breakfast type food, so that is just what we did. Here, I am taking some bacon and just cutting that in half with my scissors so that it would fit better in the air fryer basket. And I'm just gonna pop that in and cook it at 350 degrees. And I like to start checking it around 10 minutes. I love air frying bacon when it's in like smaller batches. When I have to do a larger amount, I prefer the oven. But yeah, here it is. It's nice and crispy. I love how the grease like drains down to the bottom through those holes. And then these Sweet Hawaiian flaky biscuits caught my eye at the store. We had never tried them before. We are honestly not huge fans of like canned biscuits. We just prefer homemade or the frozen kind. I really want to like the canned biscuits because of the convenience, and as silly as it sounds, I just like opening the cans. But these were okay. I probably wouldn't buy them again, mainly because my kids hated them. And Josh didn't say anything, but I've known him long enough to know that he was not impressed. Bacon, egg, and cheese is my favorite combo. When I go out to eat for breakfast, if I'm not getting biscuit and gravy, this is what I will order. I love it. And then to go along with it, we are just finishing up that leftover hash brown casserole from last week's video. And then y'all, I tried something different. This is a grape salad, and it was amazing. I filmed the whole process of me making this, so if you're interested in that, just stick around to the end of the video. Up next, I'm going to be whipping up a chicken salad. I love using a rotisserie for this. I'm not going to be following a recipe. I literally dreamt of a buffalo version of this, so I had to make it happen. If y'all know me at all, you know I am buffalo obsessed. So here I have just removed the skin, and I'm just pulling the meat from the bones. I just left it in large pieces because I am going to be shredding it with my KitchenAid mixer. I've just added in a few spoonfuls of mayo, and then I'm going to be adding in some of this Bolthouse Farms ranch dressing. It's like yogurt based, if you don't know, but if you wanted to use regular ranch, of course you can do that, or even blue cheese if that's what you prefer. Next, I'm going to be adding in some Frank's hot sauce. Josh isn't a fan of spice, but if it was up to me, I probably would have doubled that amount. And then I'm adding in some pepper and some garlic powder. I didn't add any salt because all those ingredients are pretty salty, so I knew it didn't need it. And then I'm adding in some freeze-dried chives. You could, of course, use real chives or even green onions. You could also add in some celery. We just like it, if it's cooked down, we don't like raw celery. And then I added in a little bit more hot sauce just to give it that nice orange color. And that KitchenAid mixer mixed this chicken up perfectly. It had the best consistency, and it was looking a little on the dry side, so I did end up adding in just a tad bit more of that ranch. And then I gave it a little taste test, of course, to see if I needed to add anything to it, but it was perfect. So I'm just transferring that to a nicer little bowl, and I'm just gonna pop a top on and set that in my fridge. I did this like when I first woke up, so it was super nice when it was time for dinner to just pull this out and assemble everything. I served this on croissants with some lettuce on the bottom, and then I drizzled it with some of this garlic smashed buffalo sauce to give it a little kick. I was so happy with the way this turned out. And then for the sides, I just air fried some curly fries, and then I have a fresh garden cucumber with salt and pepper. If any of you guys try this recipe, tag me on Instagram. I want to see it. I tried a new recipe for a bacon Alfredo tortellini, and it was hands down my favorite meal of the week and one of the best Pinterest recipes that I have came across. So here is the tortellini that I chose. It's in the refrigerated section. It is on the pricey side, so if you didn't want to spend that much money on it, you could of course use like the great value frozen kind. I've used that before in other recipes, and I'm sure that would be just as good. I just followed the directions on the back of the package, so I added it to some boiling salted water. I believe the cook time was like 3 minutes, and then I drained it and just set that to the side. I cooked some bacon in the oven, and so I just poured some of that grease into the bottom of this pot, and I've thrown in a big scoop of minced garlic and just sauteed that around for a couple of minutes. The best smell ever is bacon grease and garlic cooking together. And then I've added in half a block of room temperature cream cheese. I didn't sit it out in time, so I just threw it in the microwave for like 15 seconds, I believe, and that did the trick. And then here I'm just adding in some heavy whipping cream. And I'm just going to stir that until all the lumps are gone and you have a smooth sauce. And I'm going to let that simmer away. And then I'm going to add in some shredded Parmesan cheese. This kind is the best pre-shredded Parmesan cheese that I have found. It is so close to like shredding it yourself. It is awesome. And then I've just added in that cooked and crumbled bacon into the sauce. And then I'm just going to simply season it with some salt and pepper. I loved that this recipe had very few ingredients. It seems like those are always the ones that turn out the best. But now that the sauce is ready, I'm just going to toss in that tortellini and just toss everything to coat. And then here is my bowl. I just topped it with a little bit of extra shredded Parmesan cheese and then, of course, some black pepper. And then I served it with a side of roasted Brussels sprouts. I just cooked that in my air fryer with some olive oil and some garlic salt. And this was just such an impressive meal to me. I was so proud to serve it. And yeah, I think you should try it. Up next is the perfect meal for when you are in a pinch for time, and it is some grilled chicken Caesar wraps. I wanted to try out these frozen, already cooked grilled chicken breasts. I did heat those up on the grill, and then I'm using these Carb Balance tortillas, and then I'm just using the Kraft Caesar dressing. I did, of course, heat up those tortillas first, and then I added down a generous amount of that sauce, followed by a piece of romaine lettuce, and yes, I did wash it really well. And then I'm adding some of this shaved Asiago Parmesan cheese blend that is so delicious. I could eat it by itself. And then I just took the chicken and cut it down the middle and folded it up. I used to work at Wendy's back in high school, and I love their Caesar wrap, so that was kind of my inspiration. So yeah, these turned out really good, and I thought that chicken was perfect in the wrap. I have been asparagus obsessed here lately, so of course I have a side of that. And then just a simple sweet potato. I didn't top it with anything because I just like them plain a lot of the time. On Saturday, Josh and I finally went out on a date night. It has been a while since we have went out by ourselves to a nice dinner, and we chose Malone's in Lexington. That was our first time ever eating at Malone's, and it was hands down one of the best meals that we've had at a restaurant in a really long time. I got a filet mignon, best steak I've ever had, and then Josh got the fish. I gave him half my steak, and then I took one piece of his fish. And it was the best fish I've ever had as well. So that was really nice. And then the fatty in me couldn't leave without getting dessert. I mean, come on. Look at that chocolate cake. On Sunday, we did some Philly cheesesteak. So I just took a green pepper and an orange pepper and thinly sliced that. I sauteed it in some olive oil and seasoned it with some of that garlic sea salt. I cooked that until it was slightly softened but still had a crunch to it. And then I just removed it to a separate plate. I added in some more olive oil to my skillet, and then I tossed in some thinly sliced steak. It was still slightly frozen, so I took the time to kind of pick it apart, and then I seasoned it with some of the Montreal steak seasoning by McCormick. And then I also added in a few dashes of Worcestershire sauce. It didn't take long at all for this to cook. I didn't want to cook it for too long. I didn't want it to be tough or anything. And I just served that over some sub rolls. And then I heated up some of this Rico's nacho cheese sauce that we love. Super good, not too spicy. And I just added some of the sauteed peppers. The kids picked out the sides. Riley wanted some tater tots. And then Boston is obsessed with this Bob Evans mac and cheese. So I just threw that on the side, and yeah, it was a really good dinner that came together super quick. And then, as promised, the grape salad recipe. So I have 1 pound of green grapes and then 1 pound of the red or purple, whatever you want to call it, grapes, and I'm just rinsing those really well and letting that drain through my colander. These were super expensive. These were almost like $13 for this amount. So normally I put like budget friendly family meal ideas in my title. I took out the word budget just because of these grapes. But I did just drain those really well, and then I'm going to dry those the best that I can. I'm just taking some paper towels and drying them that way. And then the mom and me had to cut these grapes in half because I knew that the kids were going to eat this, and I'm just always afraid of choking. So if you have little ones, definitely recommend chopping those in half. And then for the filling, it's just some cream cheese, vanilla extract, vanilla yogurt, and some sugar. I'm not afraid to die. So after I tossed the grapes in that delicious filling, I just took some light brown sugar and sprinkled that all over the top. I'm also going to be taking some pecans and finally chopping those up and adding that as well. I didn't have many on hand. I just used what I had. But if I had more, I would totally add in a ton more because I really love that in a salad. So this was delicious, as I said. I would definitely make it again. I will say, though, the next day it got pretty runny, even though it still tasted good. So if you want to bring this to like a get-together, I would recommend preparing it the day of. But yeah, that's going to wrap up this video. I hope that you felt inspired and found something that you would like to feed your family. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.